Hi, I'm Jesse with Mastercam, and in this video, I want to show you a new toolpath in Mastercam 2021, 3+2 automatic. The goal of this video isn't to go into detail on individual toolpath parameters. Instead, we're going to look at strategies for creating a toolpath once, and then leveraging it across entire families or types of parts. Creating toolpath operations from scratch usually takes a certain amount of skill and effort. This is especially true when it comes to roughing an entire part on a 5-axis machine. The aerospace stand that I'm using for this demonstration is typical of the type of complex component that would need to be machined in the aerospace industry. The roughing for this part has already been programmed with 3+2 automatic, so let's look at it and verify. It's important to remember that the simulation is only as accurate as the information that you provide. A critical component of that is the initial stock definition. In order to set that up, I'll launch the Verify Options function. I'm going to make sure I've selected the stock model that was previously created, called Stock. I'll close the Options dialog, select the 3+2 automatic toolpath, and launch Verify. Verify is available in the Operations Manager as well as on the Machine tab. As the verification runs, we can see that the new toolpath has done a great job of gouge checking the holder against the part. It also created safe and efficient linking moves between tool planes. Now let's look at that same toolpath at the machine. The material we're cutting in this example is 6061 aluminum. With a successful first part cut, let's look at leveraging this across similar parts that we'll be machining in the future. This is where the real power of the 3+2 automatic toolpath lies. I'll start by saving this file as a template. Once it's saved, I can open the next part I need to rough machine. This is a simple power sports suspension bracket, and I'll be using the same Lang self-centering 5-axis vise for work holding. This strategy for leveraging 3+2 automatic template files works well when using the same general size part. A good guideline is to make sure that the part you're attempting to program fits in the same work holding as your template file. These suggestions are good guidelines, but the workflow I'll be demonstrating over the next few minutes will work in many other applications. First, I'll right-click in the Operations Manager and choose Import. By default, Import Operations is going to be looking for a Mastercam operations file, but we can choose a regular Mastercam part file to import operations from instead. To do this, I'll change the dropdown to the Mastercam file extension and navigate to the 3+2 template file. Next, I'll select the 3+2 automatic toolpath and click Apply. Once Mastercam indicates that the import was successful, I'll click OK and exit the import dialog. Now that the toolpath is imported, I just need to set it up to work with this new part. Thanks to the power and flexibility of 3+2 automatic, this is a simple process. If you've standardized which roughing tools are placed in which tool numbers on the machine, then the selected tooling should already be correct. Next, I'll go to the Model Geometry page and select the part as Machining Geometry with a triple click. Because this is a roughing operation, I'll leave some stock on the part. 1 millimeter should be enough. I don't want to forget about the work holding. Obviously, I don't want to collide with the vise, especially when it's something as nice as this self-centering Lang vise that I'm using. So I need to make sure to select it as avoidance geometry. I can pick the vise components individually, or I can window select all the components at once. I'll enter 5 millimeters as the clearance distance. Located on the linking page, the automatic setting is where the real flexibility of this toolpath shines. This is what allows the toolpath to adjust and resize for varying part and stock sizes. But for that to work, it needs to have the stock properly defined. The original operation was using a stock model for the initial stock shape. I could create a stock model, but instead I'll use the User Selected Geometry option. In the Levels Manager, I'll turn on the level with my stock and select it. Now, all I need to do is regenerate the toolpath. In a short amount of time and with little effort, I have a toolpath that roughs all sides of my part. And this is without the need to create extra geometry, planes, containments, or part-specific parameter setup. Creating this complex operation from scratch wouldn't be this easy if it weren't for the ability to leverage my template file and imported operation. Now let's look at it and verify to ensure I have a safe, gouge-free toolpath and I didn't miss anything. Keep in mind, this isn't the most controlled or efficient way to rough this part. Using something like the OptiRest toolpath with in-process stock models would be a superior method, but that would take more time and effort. There is simply no faster or less complicated way to get a part on the machine and roughing as with the 3+2 automatic toolpath. As Verify finished up, it's clear that I've forgotten something. The part is floating in midair, which obviously won't work. This is a great example of why it's important to always use tools like Backplot, Verify, and Simulation before cutting a part at the machine. I modeled a support structure previously that I need to make sure to select as additional avoidance geometry. Now I can regenerate the toolpath and look at it and verify again. Now that I've fixed this last issue, the verification looks good. Now it's time to cut it on the machine. I need to emphasize how critical it is to understand what you are looking to get out of your programming and machining process before utilizing the new 3+2 automatic toolpath. If minimizing skill and programming lead time is the most important thing to you, then this new toolpath may revolutionize the way you work. However, if you are looking for maximum efficiency while maintaining incredibly fine control over the roughing on your 5-axis machine, OptiRest and stock models are the ideal solution. Either way, I hope this quick look into leveraging the new 3+2 automatic toolpath has spurred some thought into how you might integrate this into your process and make the most out of your investment into Mastercam and 5-axis machining.